Good morning, my name is Guy and welcome to my shop. I'm going to start a new project today. I really don't know what to call it. It's kind of a cross between a writing desk and a secretary. I'm going to be doing it the federal style, something I've never done before. And we pulled this off of Google through their images, and my wife really liked it. She liked the architectural details of it. She liked these alcoves. Now, I'm going to have to get rid of these underneath here, and the main reason is there's some size considerations where this has to go, and this is going to be much smaller, I think, than the original piece. So these pigeonholes underneath here will be much smaller than really they have a function. So another nice thing, it's hard to tell from the photograph, but I also found some other photographs of this piece. This is a tambour door that slides in a track that hides behind these details. So I'm going to start by actually building the hutch first and then working my way down, mainly because I really don't know exactly how I'm going to do the legs yet. As typical, I have some rough sketches and some drawings and things of how I'm going to put this together. It's mostly going to be put together on the fly. So I already cut the bottom of the hutch and the subtop for the hutch. This is going to be the base, this is the front, and I've already done this one already, so you can see how that tambour is going to go around this groove. Now I've got the other piece here in my bench, and what these are, there's some spacers. I've got a form that I've made, or a pattern that I've made, that I'm using to route that with, and I just need to pull off some sticky tape there, and making sure that I'm keeping the front with the front and the back with the back, because I need to make mirror images of one another based on the wood grain I've selected. I'm just going to put those on there and press that in place. Now I'll be able to take my router with the template bit and go around this piece right here. And again, that will be a mirror image of this one. I'm using a 1/4-inch downcut spiral bit to do this. I've got a collar set up in my router. I'm going to make this in 3 passes. Basically what I'm doing is I'm going to make a plunge, go around. I've got starting and stopping points based on the edge of the router that I can go all the way around and make those grooves. Well, that's one half of this side done. Now I just need to flip this over and do the other side. Well, here's both the top and the bottom pieces of the hutch done. I should say this is the subtop. If you notice here, the front here, again, these are mirror images. The front on the bottom is much wider than it is on the subtop. And that's because when these are put together like this, this is going to be that ledge that's in the front, and that's going to allow me to put those architectural details that are in the front of the piece. And so I need to start doing now is I need to start getting these ready for the joinery, and of course making the sides and the interior case pieces. This is how I'm going to attach the sides to the bottom and subtop of the hutch. Now they're going to be held in by rabbets. I don't want to see any end grain on the sides of the cabinet. I've already marked out which pieces are going to receive the rabbet. This is the bottom piece. Now, on this side, or I should say on the bottom of the hutch, these need to be stop rabbets. I've already made some marks. I'll carry those over the top, so when I go through the router, I'll be able to stop. Another thing I'm a little concerned about, too, is when I'm doing the end grain on these, I'm concerned that I'm going to have about 1/8 of an inch left over for where that tambour door slides around. I'm a little bit concerned about that splitting out. So I've cut some filler pieces that are just going to go in there, and they're going to make sure that I'm going to try to minimize anyways those being blown out on the ends. So I'm just going to go over the router table and do that. Now on the subtop, those rabbets can go all the way through to the end. I'm going to start cutting the rabbets in the sides and the bottom and subtop of the hutch. I've got a 3/8-inch rabbeting bit set in my router table. The speed is the next to the slowest. I want to make sure I get nice and slow through this. I'm going to do this in 2 passes. Now, another nice thing about having a split fence is I can have the start and stop point of the bit itself. So when I get ready to do the base of the hutch, I can make those stop rabbets. Well, the next thing I need to do, I need to make up some 3/8 inch stock, and that's going to be for the dividers for the shelves. Now, if you can see this piece right here, that's what I'm going to use. There is a hell of a little bend on there. I need to cut that off first before I restock this piece. So I'm just going to lay it flat, find out where that bow in the board ends, give myself a little extra. I'm just going to cut that off right there. And that will give me 42 inch length, which should be plenty enough to get the pieces that I need after I resaw them. So after I've got that piece cut off and bowed on the end, I'm going to be able to run this through the joint or the face joint to get it flat. Now there's still a little bit of a rock in here. If I turn it over, it's pretty stable. If I keep pressure on it at the same point when I'm running it over the jointer, I'll be able to get one flat face. And it's not look like I'm going to lose too much, so I'm going to go face down like this on the jointer. So I've got one face flattened on the jointer, and I just want to make sure I still have enough thickness here, which I do. I still got a full inch. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to joint one edge perpendicular to this. And then I'm going to go over to the bandsaw and I'm going to resaw this down. So this is what I've done so far on this. I've gone in 2 inches from this end, and that's going to be enough to clear the, when the sides go in like this, that's going to be enough for the tambour to clear that. So I went 2 inches in, then I want 1/8 inch off of each end of this, and then from here I want 3/4 inch, and I want to give myself some extra clearance for knobs that are going to go in the drawers. I don't have those knobs yet, but most of the small ones aren't going to be larger than that. I'll make sure to find some that are. So then I've got 3/4 inch there, and then again 3/8 inch off the back for 1/8 inch spacing, then 1/4 inch back. If I measure between those two spots, I've got 5.5 inches. So I need to make the width of the sides that are going to go inside the cabin or in the hutch 5.5 inches wide, and they're going to be 8.5 inches tall. So this is the last minute sanity check for me before I start cutting the dados in here. They're going to be stop dados, and there are going to be some compartments for the shelves in the bottom compartment. So they need to be 2.5 inches deep. So I'll mark 2.5 inches. And then I've got a 3/8 inch dado for the shelf. So that's 2 7/8. And then I need to go down to 5 3/8, which again is the adding 2.5 inches. And then another 3/8 inch, which is 5 3/4. And that should leave me 2 3/4 on the bottom, so it's a little bit taller on the bottom, and that's okay. And I need to make that stop dado about 1/2 inch from the front. So I'm just going to mark that now. I'll find the mark. There it is. And I'll cut those on the router table with a 3/8 inch bit. Okay, I've got the router table set up to make this cut. I've got 2.5 inches from the edge of this. It's a 3/8 inch bit, 3/8 inch above the table. And I put a couple stops. Now remember, I have to make mirror images of these because they'll be stop dados in the front of it. So the first set, got this stop set up with this bar raised on this one. I'll push these through on both of those. And then for the second side, I'm going to lift these up and put this one down, keeping the stops there. And then I'll be able to make passes like this with the plunge down and then go all the way through. All right, so this is what I'm looking for. This is the top of the piece and this is the bottom of the piece. I've got my 2.5 inches here, 2.5 inches in the middle, and 2¾ inches on the bottom. And again, I have mirrored sides for both. Based on what I know about the pieces that are going to go inside the hutch, those need to be 13¼ inches long. These 3¾-inch material, I cut 3/8-inch grooves in those. So that leaves me with 12.5 inches. So I need 4 pieces, 12.5 inches long. And I'm just going to cut those here at the miter saw. This is one of the pieces I just cut on the table saw, and I've already squared up the corners in those rabbets. Those are going to fit in here like this. I'll push them all the way up. Now, I'm going to need to cut some notches in these shelves, or in these dividers, I should say, so that they come all the way to the front. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to push them in there, make sure they're seated flat. I'm going to take my marking knife, and I'm just going to cut that. I should say make a mark right where that hits it. Now that I've done that, I can take this out and I can hold it up against the back flush. And then just make a tick mark where the edge of that is. So all I need to do is cut those. I'm just going to do that with a handsaw. I've cut that out, and this is what I really am looking for. I push that in there and slide it in. We've got a nice tight joint here, and I'm about a 32nd of an inch proud from the front of this. And again, that's exactly what I want. So I'll just go ahead and cut the rest of them. Well, now you can see how this is going to go together a little bit more. These are going to be centered on there, about 1/8 of an inch back, again, so the tambour can roll around. I do want to make a divider on top here. I've marked the center line for these. There's going to be another stop dado along here. And I need to make the same stop dado along the top here. And I will do that at the router table. I'm getting ready to cut the stop grooves or the stop dados in the subtop. I've got the same 3/8-inch bit in my router. I've got a template collar or a guide bushing on here. I've got a spacer block, and I'm 99.9% sure my math is correct. So if I put it here, and I've got some starting and stopping points for the router, that this is all going to work out, and that divider is going to be perfectly perpendicular in there. So here's the first stopped dado cut in here. Now, if my math was correct, and I know it was because I checked this before I turned the camera on, 2¾ inches over from the end is where the edge of this should be, and that should line up with my groove in the board. And it does, so I'm real happy with that. I just need to do the other side, and then I need to cut the pieces that go on the top. So I got these pieces semi-put together, got a couple clamps holding them. What I really want to do is want to get the measurement from the bottom of this dado up into the groove. So I marked where the stop of that dado is right there, the depth of that dado is. And going to the bottom of this, I've got 3⅛ inches. Well, here's the dry fit of the case, and it came out pretty good. There's a couple mistakes, there's a couple gaps here and there. But I can live with those. Most of them will be covered up by some of the architectural details that I'm going to put on the piece.